the Marching Cube tutorial. This project is based on Can You Roll Box in Blender by Default Cube tutorial on how to roll cube. It's a great tutorial, I'll put the link in the descriptions. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make a cube roll and instance it on a grid by using geometry nodes. This file is available on my GoPro. Let's get started. First, let's start by adding the default cube in Blender and opening the geometry nodes editor. To make the cube rotate, you could use the transform geometry node, then animate the rotation. However, we also need to adjust the pivot point. For this project, the pivot point will be set here. Instead of using transform geometry, we need to use the set position node. We'll rotate the cube based on its position using the vector rotate node, which allow us to control the pivot point. As you know, the default cube in Blender is 2 × 2 × 2 meters. To shift the pivot point to the corner, we need to move it 1 meter along the x-axis and negative 1 meter along the z-axis. In the vector rotate node, set the x-axis to 1 and the z-axis to -1. And set the second row in the axis tab to 1. This way, the pivot will rotate around y-axis. For the first step, the cube will rotate 90 degrees. For the second step, the cube will again rotate 90 degrees around the y-axis. But since the pivot point shifts after the first step, it's now 3 meters from the origin instead of 1 meter, while the Z position remains the same. Following this pattern, the next step will move the pivot point by 5 meters, then 7 meters and so on. That's the basic explanation of how to rotate the cube. Now we will try to automate that animation. We will still need the vector rotate and position nodes, so this will stay in place. Remember how the pivot point moved by 1, 3, 5 and 7 meters? This sequence follows the formula of 2n plus 1. Use the scene time node as the driving input. As time progresses, it will continuously add the rotation and translation in the vector rotate node. We'll use the math node, set it to multiply by 2, and then add 1 to generate this sequence. The effect only the x-axis, will use combine xyz node, set z to -1, and we'll leave y as it is. For the rotation, the angle will change from 0 to 90 degrees for each second. From 0 to 1 second, the cube rotates from 0 to 90 degrees. From 1 to 2 seconds, it resets and rotates again, repeating the pattern. To achieve this, we'll use a fraction node, which keeps only the decimal part of a value. If you graph it, the result looks like a salted wave. Next, we'll multiply this by 90 degrees. Since Blender uses radians, we'll convert it using pi divided by 2, which equals 90 degrees. We have the basic animation now, but it's not perfect yet. We need to use vector math to translate the cube along the x-axis. Now the animation should look closer to what we want.
The issue now is the decimal progression from the scene time node causing the cube to drift. What we want from the scene time node is only the integer values, which when graphed should create a step. However, because the scene time node currently produces decimal points, the graph looks more like a gradient, which causes the cube to drift.
To fix this, run down the translation using the matplotlib node. And done, the basic cube rotation is ready. Now let's add a scaling function so we can adjust the cube size in the modifier panel. Using the transform geometry node, we'll connect the scale to the group input. Change the input type from vector to float and reset the scale to 1. Now we can control the scale from geometry node modifier. The translation and pivot points need to be adjusted based on the cube size. We'll use the group input node to get the scale value, multiply it by 2, and then by the rounded seconds to keep everything proportional. So let me explain. Since the cube size changed, we need to update the 2n plus 1 sequence accordingly. For example, if the cube size changed, we need to add to the constant by multiplying the scale. The same goes for the negative z-axis translation, multiplied by the scale value with the minus 1. Now we can adjust the cube size and maintain the rotation animation. And if you notice, the first frame's rotation is a little bit off. And that's because the scene time node start at the frame 1, not 0. To fix this, either you can start the animation from frame 0 or subtract one frame from the scene time.
Since my current Blender scene is at 24 frames per second,
I'll subtract the scene time with the value of 1 divided by 24. You can also adjust the animation speed by multiplying the scene time here.
Now we will start to populate the scene using a grid node. We need to add a grid node, plug it into the group output, and add an instance on point node. Then use the rotating cube node setup that we just created and plug it into the instance node.
Next, adjust the grid size so the cubes don't collide with each other during animation. Honestly, I found this value through trial and error. There's likely a mathematical relationship between cube size and grid size to prevent collision. If you figure it out, let me know in the comment. Next, we need to disable the even number cubes using a mat modulo node based on the cube's index and set it to. A set of cubes moving in a different direction. Duplicate the current setup by pressing Shift D, move it up, and rotate it by 90 degrees.
And that's it for the geometry node section.
Material, add the set material node after set position node. We will add the material in the shader editor.
Here is how the final result will look like. I also added a simple plane with a grid shader. For the cube's color, I use an object info node to get the random value, where it actually produces a random number between 0 and 1, so like a random grayscale value. Then you can use this to drive custom colors through a color ramp node. So in the color ramp, set the type to constant and add as many colors as you want.
Then plug it into the principal BSDF shader.
cube's look, I tweak the roughness and subsurface scattering to give it a translucent effect. The unused color ramp is for additional color variations. I also added the bevel modifier to the cube before the geometry nodes modifier. And that's it everyone, thank you for watching.